You are listening to the audio production of Food Saved Me, My Journey of Finding Health and Hope Through the Power of Food by Danielle Walker, published by Tyndale Refresh. This book is read by the author. Please note that you may download accompanying PDFs that provide enhanced materials for this audiobook at tyndale.life/foodsavedme. For my grandma Marge, you instilled an appreciation for family and community in me from an early age, and you taught me what it looks like to show affection through the food we make and the conversations around our tables with the ones we love. The information contained in this book is based on my experience and personal research. It is not intended to replace consultation with your physician or other healthcare provider. Diagnosis and treatment of an illness should be done under the direction of a healthcare professional. The names and identifying details of the physicians and some of the other people who appear in this book have been changed to protect their privacy. A note from me to you. This audiobook is the story of how food saved my life. It's also a love story about loving food, loving family, loving friends, and loving myself enough to take an active role in managing my own health. I have experienced a decade-long cycle of diagnosis, disease, remission, setbacks, recovery, and loss, but one thing has held true. Food continues to save me. And my mission is to help you understand all the different ways food can help save you too. If you have used my cookbooks or followed my blog or Instagram page for a while, you've probably read snippets of my story here and there, but until now, I've never done a deep dive. If you don't know me, let me introduce myself. I'm Danielle. I'm a wife, mom, and self-taught grain-free, gluten-free, and mostly dairy-free cook and baker from the San Francisco Bay Area. When I was 22, I was diagnosed with an extreme form of ulcerative colitis, an autoimmune disease that viciously attacks an otherwise healthy colon, resulting in severe and, in my case, life-threatening malabsorption, malnutrition, and anemia. In the first few years following my diagnosis, I was so sick, I had to be hospitalized multiple times, and on more than one occasion, I required emergency blood transfusions and iron infusions just to stay alive. With each flare-up, my weight would fluctuate drastically. It wasn't unusual for me to lose as many as 20 to 25 pounds within a matter of weeks. That rapid weight loss would often lead to arthritis-like pain in all my joints, a ridiculously rapid heart rate, hair loss, energy loss, and a host of other problems. Much to my dismay, my husband Ryan and I spent the better part of our first year as husband and wife in and out of emergency rooms and doctor's offices. We were unable to travel, stray too far from home, or even enjoy an evening out with friends and family for fear of what might happen if I had another flare-up. In an attempt to manage my symptoms, my doctors prescribed high doses of steroids and other medications, the side effects of which were often as bad as, if not worse, than the disease itself. When I asked them whether food might affect my condition, each physician told me the same thing. Diet didn't cause it, diet can't help it, and diet can't cure it. But as I continued relying solely on the prescriptions, my symptoms only worsened. My sickness controlled my life until I decided to take matters into my own hands and drastically change my diet. After doing some research, I decided to stick to unrefined whole foods, the way people ate before the agricultural revolution changed the way food is grown and processed. I like to say it's the way humans were designed to eat before mass production ruined food and before convenience and immediate gratification largely displaced fresh, healthy, and real foods. My diet centers on grass-fed or pasture-raised proteins, fish, vegetables, fruit, seeds, nuts, and healthy fats. It eliminates dairy, legumes, grain products, sugar, gluten, and all processed foods. Almost immediately after I changed my diet, my symptoms began to subside, which was the sign of hope I needed to press forward. But virtually every dish I loved growing up had at least one, if not multiple, ingredients on my can't have list. That triggered a whole new list of fears and concerns. Does this mean I'll never again be able to enjoy all the rich, creamy, sumptuous foods of my childhood? Who's going to want to come to our house for a meal or a holiday celebration knowing I'll only be serving grain-free, gluten-free, sugar-free, and dairy-free food? Will people even feel comfortable inviting me to their homes and special events knowing I probably can't eat what they're serving? How will I eat when I'm traveling? When I have children of my own, how will I pass down all of the food traditions and memories I grew up with? My guess is that you have many of the same questions. And believe me, I get it. When you're forced to alter your diet drastically for the sake of your health, it's natural to worry that much of what makes life worth living will be lost along with your newly eliminated food groups. It's understandable to worry that you will miss out on special occasions with family and friends or be unable to provide homemade cookies for a child's party. And if you're anything like me, you're probably also worried that you'll never again be able to experience the joy that comes from lovingly preparing and serving food to the people you care about. Well, over 10 years, thousands of recipes, and 3 New York Times bestselling cookbooks later, I promise you, you can effectively manage your symptoms while still enjoying truly amazing food. The process may not be perfectly smooth, and you may hit bumps and setbacks like I have, but your entire life can change for the better. When I embarked on this new food journey, I assumed it could only help those like me with digestive diseases. But since that day, I have received hundreds of thousands of emails and listened to personal accounts during my book tours from people all over the world who have experienced relief from everything from Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis, multiple sclerosis, Hashimoto's disease, type 1 diabetes, rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, and psoriasis to autism, infertility, migraines, and food allergies. I've also received positive feedback from people without specific diagnosis whose brain fog, restless sleep, and everyday aches and pains cleared up after altering their diet. They're all managing their health while enjoying nutritious, great-tasting meals that even their friends and families love to eat. Odds are, if you are listening to this book, you or someone you know is struggling with some kind of autoimmune disease or other malady, and you're wondering if changing your diet can help. The short answer is yes. It most definitely can. The slightly longer answer lies in the chapters that follow. If you're new to grain, gluten, and dairy-free living, I want you to know that you are not alone. Hundreds of millions of people around the world suffer from various types of autoimmune diseases, and millions more from food allergies or chronic ailments. While diet may not provide a complete cure, changing how and what you eat can help you manage your health and significantly reduce both the frequency and the severity of flare-ups. I would bet my life on it. In fact, I have. That's why I have written this book. I want to share my journey so that you will know that there is a path forward, there is healing, and there is hope. In fact, if you take nothing else from my story, I pray it will be that. There is hope. Hope that you can live a full, happy, and healthy life without ever feeling hungry, excluded, or deprived. Hope that with each setback, comes new learning and a renewed sense of determination, and hope that food can radically change your life for the better. I know it can. I've experienced it. So have millions of others. Now it's your turn.
Food saved me from cancer twice and Hashimoto's.
Food saved me from lupus inflammation.
Food saved me from having miscarriages and blessed me with healthy babies.
Food saved me by getting my MS under control. I went from taking daily shots and needing a walking aid to no shots.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.